So let me talk about dynamic programming with stochastic actions. And at the end of this assignment, you'll be able to program this. The motivation to study this is as follows. Suppose we have a robot, and we have an obstacle, and a goal state. Then this robot might be tempted to scratch the wall over here and head towards the goal. In practice, this is a bad idea because robots that get really close to obstacles are frightening. And in fact, if their actions aren't quite perfect, they might actually hit the obstacle, which is no good. So in practice, what we tend to do is we go more like this. We maintain a certain clearance to obstacles. And now we're going to modify our dynamic programming planner to do just that, to find paths that are a little bit safer and lead a little bit away from obstacles. The way we will do this is we will model actions as stochastic. And we have not done this before, but you learn how to do it. Take the action of going north from the cell over here. In a deterministic action, it always succeeds, unless, of course, we run into a wall. In the stochastic case, it succeeds with a certain probability, say 50%. Whereas with 25% chance, it might accidentally go left or right, even though we commanded it to go up. This is a stochastic action, and it's exactly the type of action I want you to program later on. If, for example, there was a wall over here, and the robot decided to go up, then with 25% chance it would hit the wall, which is not good. So staying away from a wall is a good idea in a stochastic situation. I will now show you how the backup works without asking your quizzes. Suppose we study the action of going up over here, and we have a 50% chance of success. And suppose at the time we do the backup, the value over here is 10, 20 over here, and 40 on the right. Then the value of the state for the action go up would be obtained as follows. It's 50% chance times 10, 25% chance times 20, and 25% chance times 40, plus 1, which is our motion cost, which together gives me 5 plus 5 plus 10 plus 1 equals 21. That is the backed up value over here for the action go up. And you can do the same with go right, go left, go down. The interesting case in your implementation is the one for an action that either runs off the grid or into a wall. So let's study the case of going north from this cell over here, where there's a 25% chance of falling off the grid. Then the value for the cell and the action of going north is 50% times 20, which is 10, 25% chance times 40, which is also 10. And then we have this case where you fall off the wall. And let's define the penalty for falling off the grid or for hitting an obstacle, 100. So we add 25% chance times 100 plus 1. Hence the new value is 10 plus 10 plus 25 plus 1, which is 46. So I want your update to produce for the cell over here 46. For the specific action of going up, of course, the value might be smaller because there might be a better action, like the action of going right. But for this specific calculation, you should receive 46. So your programming assignment looks as follows. I will give you a grid. In this case, it's a grid that's entirely unoccupied. And as before, I give you a goal state and a set of actions. And I want you to program dynamic programming all the way to the end. So when I run it, the values I get are 0 for the goal state, 37 for the two adjacent states, 44, 60, and 63. So if I go right to the goal, there's a 50% chance of hitting the goal, in which case my cost is just 1, which is the cost of motion. There's a 25% chance of running into the wall, which costs me 100, plus, of course, 1 for the forward motion. And there's a 25% chance I find myself down here, whose cost is 44. So if I put this into mathematics, we get 50% chance for hitting the goal, 25% for hitting a wall, which costs me 100, 25% for going south, and the value here is 44.77, plus the cost of motion is 1. And if you add this all up, you get exactly the 37.193 that this value over here constitutes. So after convergence for this grid, I want the value function to look just like this. And here is the corresponding policy. If I modify the grid to insert an obstacle over here, then I get a value function like this. 1000 is my initial value for each cell. It's unmodified for the obstacle cell. And these are the values I receive, 94, 86, 73, 44. You can check whether these values are correct. Let me pick a slightly bigger grid with a goal position in the top right corner and two obstacles down here, size 4x4. And here's my output for the value function. You can read those values. They happen to be 1,000 for the two obstacles. And what's remarkable is the policy. When I'm close to the wall, you can see they're being pulled away from those wall, from the wall elements to stay in free space. I will eventually reach the goal, but I never am willing to drive in a way that crashes me into a wall if it's not avoidable. What you have to do with the code we provide is to modify the dynamic programming routine that assumes a deterministic action with the one for a stochastic action. And specifically, what this routine should do, it should incorporate the probability of success for an action and the collision costs. So for example, if I modify the probability of success into a deterministic function, then my value function will look as follows. It's just the number of steps in the usual way, 1, 2, 3, as before, and the policy drives me straight to the goal as shown over here. In your final submission, please exclude any printouts so we can modify the grid and these values for success probability and collision costs, and we can see what your code generates. In your initial value function, please initialize your value function with 1000.